Mailing lists have been a cornerstone of the FOSS world since basically the start of the FOSS world. And today, by far the biggest, is the LKML, the Linux Kernel Mailing List. The majority of the upstream work in the kernel is done through email. But most long-running projects either have or had a mailing list in the past. Things like OpenSUSE, they have a bunch of them. We have Arch Linux, and most things under the Free Desktop banner, also the same. Things like Wayland, Pipewire, and a bunch of others. Now, whilst things like the LKML are still very active, as this is the primary way that development discussion is done, this is just the messages from yesterday. This is not the case for most other mailing lists out there. As a random example, this is Wayland Vel from February of 2025. That is all of it. This is Wayland Vel from February 2016. Now, it's certainly not as big as the LKML, but it's a lot more active. Now, that's not because the project is dead. Far from it. Wayland is more active than ever, but communication is not primarily done through the mailing list. And this isn't just a Wayland problem. Basically, every project that has other methods of communication, those other methods are more popular. Nowadays, for less important discussions, a lot of projects have a Discord or a Matrix, or some of them might still have a very active IRC. When it comes to submitting patches, a lot of projects make use of something like a GitHub or a GitLab, which has a built-in issue tracker, which is the work you would likely be doing on the mailing list. And if they use one of those platforms, maybe you don't do issue tracking on that platform, they likely have an external Bugzilla or something like that, which also serves the purpose of that mailing list discussion. Now, if you're the Linux kernel, you can do whatever you want and people are gonna jump through hoops to get involved in the project because, you know, it's the Linux kernel. It's such an important project. People are paid to work on that project and they will do some stupid things to get involved in development. But if you're just some random Joe Schmo project, with less and less projects using mailing lists, it's becoming a lot harder to onboard people into these development practices because there's not the general expectation that you understand how a mailing list works, you understand mailing list etiquette, because you're most likely used to things like GitHub and GitLab. And this is a problem that is going to continue to spiral and spiral until less and less projects use them. So with all that, is it time to move away from the humble mailing list? Now, if you're the LKML, you're gonna keep doing LKML things. It's not losing popularity. Maybe 15, 20 years from now, the Linux kernel is gonna move away from that structure, but there's no indication today. But what about for a project like Ubuntu? Well, some people over on Ubuntu want to make this move happen. Announced over on the mailing list, moving to discourse from mailing lists. As I've said in prior videos, that is discourse, not Discord. Discourse, for better or worse, is a popular open source forum software, and Ubuntu already does make use of it. It's just they also have the mailing list from the early days of the project. So this isn't about creating a new discourse. The Ubuntu discourse is popular in the world of Ubuntu. This is the way that a lot of announcements are done. This is the way a lot of development is done. This is a thing that a lot of people in the Ubuntu world make use of. What this is about is sunsetting the mailing list and anything that is still being done over here, moving over here. And this is following a recent move from IRC over to Matrix. Now, I had no idea this was going on, but this happened really recently. Announced back in January of this year, and starting from March 1st, 2025, which is 24 days ago as a recording, the primary official real-time communication channels for Ubuntu developers will be on Matrix. To avoid fragmentation of conversation, Ubuntu developers should please make sure they're appropriately present on Matrix and conduct conversation there instead of the now deprecated IRC channels. I guess they could have bridged them together, and some projects do actually do that, but it does make moderation an absolute disaster. So regarding instead the discourse and the mailing list, I can't be alone in finding an extra effort to track both. And this is exactly why one of them, quite popular, the other... This is all of the messages so far in March. Yeah, it seems like most people don't actually track both of them. Could the key Ubuntu developer lists move over to Discourse entirely so there's one fewer place where key Ubuntu development communications happen? I note that Ubuntu Desktop has essentially made the move already. And as I said earlier, this problem that Ubuntu has is not an Ubuntu exclusive problem. If you have a mailing list or an IRC and then something wildly better as an option, people are going to use the wildly better as an option. You might be old and you might be used to the way these older systems work, but if people have grown up with something newer and they're more used to that, naturally that's where they're going to go. Regarding this move as opposed to the IRC to matrix move, personally I'm less sure this time, because I haven't found a way for various mailing list workflows to work on Discourse myself, but I'm open to figuring out how to make it work. In response to my concern, Ian Weiser has kindly offered to spend some time with me and anyone else similarly skeptical to figure out how the mailing list workflows would map over to Discourse. Now, Discourse, if set up correctly by the Discourse people moderating it, can be interacted with over email. So you can kind of treat it like a mailing list. But if you've been using mailing lists for what? Ubuntu's been around for 21 years now. You're obviously going to have workflows, especially if you're someone who's been around since the very early days of the project. And trying to modify those workflows, even if everything you can be done, might not be as clear and might need some additional, you know, teaching and learning to work out what you need to do. So this is now an offer to all Ubuntu developers, especially those skeptical about deprecating Ubuntu developer mailing lists, to help give Discourse a fair shot by allowing Ian to suggest alternative workflows that will work for you. Now, as a further indication of how dead this mailing list is, let's go to Thread. There are 3 replies about ending the mailing list. 3. This was first posted 7 days ago. And I'd like to highlight the reply from Aaron Rainbolt, who probably isn't related to Trevor Rainbolt, the GeoGuessr guy. But let me know. So many of the people here, stop right there, there's not many of them, that's sort of the problem, probably saw me go on a minor rant in devel.ubuntu.com about wanting to keep the mailing list, then backpedal. I'll basically try to condense down my thoughts here, but ultimately I'd say I'm a week plus one on the move. First, some reasons I sort of don't want to see the move happen, but not badly enough to make me minus one. If you want to use other terminology, that would be an ack or a knack. Discourse is not my favorite piece of software to use. If it is for anyone, you probably haven't used much software. The people who are actually helping run it for Ubuntu are doing a fantastic job, and the actual community there is amazing. But the software is just meh. There isn't a tree view of the conversation. Everything is just stuffed into one long thread as if each comment was just a reply to the comment immediately before it. There's some hints in the user interface to help you determine who's replying to who, but they're minimal, sometimes ambiguous, and clunky to use. As an example, here is a random thread from the forum. It has 769 comments. So if you scroll through it, you'll notice there are things like @s here, or this one right here. When it's directly after it, you know, it's easy enough to work what's going on. But then when it's further down, it has this reply button here, which will then link you to the other post and you can jump to that post. But when there is a bunch of comments in here, it very quickly becomes an absolute mess. Now, criticize Reddit for the people on Reddit, the way the platform is run, but Reddit purely as a piece of forum software works really well. And I have no idea why you wouldn't just copy it. Discourse lazy loads pieces of the conversation. This is a headache when you're trying to scroll through a conversation quickly. You have to wait for more of the conversation to load before you can keep scrolling. So again, let's go to the long thread. When you first open up the thread, it's gonna load a number of comments, but let's quickly scroll down. As you can see, as we go down, we get to a point where it just stops showing any comments and has to load the rest. Now, this is a good thing, because otherwise, for a thread this long, you know, it would be impossible to load everything at any reasonable speed. But at the same time, when you're doing everything in plain text, like you have with the LKMO archives, like you have with the Ubuntu mailing list archives, you can just load everything quickly because it's just plain text. There is a widget in the upper right corner of the screen for seeing where you actually are in the conversation, since you can't rely on the browser scroll bar to tell you that. And it can be used for speed scrolling, but that's one more thing to keep track of, cluttering the UI and increasing the cognitive load when trying to read through things. That is this bar right here. I can jump right here. It will then load things, and there we go. You can also drag through here quickly and go exactly to where you want to go. But again, if it hasn't loaded it, it then needs to load it. The search tool is just bad, objectively bad. I would say it absolutely sucks, and I have no idea why it's like this. I don't know what's wrong with how search is implemented on discourse, but I can't remember the last time I searched for something on any discourse-powered forum and actually found it. Better yet, control F. It hijacks the search function until you press it again and then gives you the actual search. This is a big no-no. Never, ever do this. And here's another random problem. Sometimes it'll snap you back to different points in the page, which is also very nice and makes things easy to keep track of. Anytime that I need to deal with discourse, what I'll usually do is try to load up the entire page, then do my control Fs and find what I need to find, because lazy loading it like this just, it just makes it so inconvenient to use. When it eventually gets to the end, then it just works properly, but this is just annoying. And of course, this is a long thread, and it's especially annoying, but even short threads have the exact same problem. The UI is just non-obvious in many ways. For instance, until today, I had no idea how to subscribe to a category. As it turns out, there's a bell icon in the upper right corner of the screen that lets you do this, but it's not in an obvious spot, and I wasn't sure if subscribing to a category was even possible until Eric pointed it out to me today. There's no way to download archives of conversations on Discourse, so you can work with them locally, to my awareness. This is compounded with the non-functional search issue. If the search can't work, at least let me download things so I can grep through them. Also, this means referencing conversations while offline is impossible, which is not an issue with a mailing list, because all you do is download the emails. Tags are confusing. Are they categories? Are they lightweight categories? How do they help you find things? Do they even help you find things? They just don't make sense to me. I add them to my posts, but not because I have any idea what anyone will do with them later. And finally, I like plain text email. I know it's 2025. No one uses plain text email for FOSS projects, but I like it. Well, people do in the LKML, and that's pretty much it. I don't agree with this point, but the rest of these, all of these are completely legitimate problems that Discourse has. But it's not all bad. Ubuntu's development mailing lists are just about dead from what I can see. The conversations there are short, and the above issues wouldn't really present many problems if those conversations were had on Discourse. Most of the problems happen in long threads. Now, some of them are just general discourse problems, but if these, like, 3-4 comment threads were moved over, it'd be fine. Put it out of its misery. This right here is probably one of the longest months they actually had. That is January, when they discussed moving from IRC over to Matrix. And even that didn't make it that long of a thread. Here, we have Ubuntu from 2013. You can see my point. The above problems are all things I have to deal with anyway. Ubuntu uses Discourse. That's already done. So whether I like it or not, lazy loading and squished conversation trees are in my future. thus preventing the move won't really help anything. It sucks, Ubuntu chose to suck, so I might as well start sucking. The mailing lists are being overrun by spam. Well, that spam must not be getting archived because I haven't seen anything in that way. No idea why. It wasn't like this not too long ago. Now it is like this. Assuming it actually is being overrun by spam and it's just not being archived, this is just a general internet issue when you have a lack of verification on something. Spam happens. There's more bots on the internet than ever. Welcome. Welcome to the modern era. And I'll get notifications about new things on Discourse in my email if I subscribe to the right categories so I won't miss out on things. Discourse is by no means perfect, but Ubuntu has basically just moved entirely over to Discourse anyway, and the mailing list is kind of just here because it's always been here, but not many people use it. Most of the stuff is done over here or over in the Matrix. So this is on its last legs. And at some point, it needs to be done away with because it's never going to fully die. There's always going to be like one or two people that use it. But does that really justify its continued existence? I don't know. Let me know your thoughts down below. And what do you think about other projects that happen to still make use of a mailing list? Do you think it is time for them to get rid of it? Do they even still actively use it? Or is most discussion done on another platform? I'd love to know. Let me know about your favorite projects down below. And if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Berope, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and let's have some discourse. Daytime,